37. Oh, the tide has turned.
Yeah, all right. That should be good enough for a take.
That's
out of here. Grand slam for Alina Mendoza.
Got a little dance. Ashley Westco, that's what it is.
He's going to have to catch him coming through. Oh, we caught him. And tightened it up. Oh, he's got the leg in. Oh, there's a ball.
Seconds. One. He's got a shot. And it's no good. And the Knights survive. The Knights take down the Vikings in a huge
little girl got
a lock and down for a kill.
Baby, I'm howling for you. Swing and miss.
Finds the best Mendoza. Fucking scared.
And she put it in.
Baby, I'm howling for you.
And it is deep. Looks like Josie
got
just
it.
Changed the score,
got
and
it.
She did. That's a home run for our pitcher, Josie Plum. And that's what's happening.
Oh, nice, Nora.
Back to the...
Oh, oh, there's a big shot to left field.
It's
gone.
It's a grand slam.
Grand slam.
That Epps fires to the end zone. Caught! Steven! Touchdown!
Baseball fans, a couple of quick announcements from the concession stand. It is chilly out there, and they are here to take care of...
Welcome to Memorial Field, everyone, for another great day of Knights baseball. This is Brent Leniger, joined by Dan Vierling. We're going to be calling the game for you today.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Knights Nation.
So the Knights, 4-0 on the season, are welcoming Ely down. They made the long trip for a Friday afternoon game.
They did, yep. We got some more tomorrow. International Falls and Cherry will be here, I believe, tomorrow, 1 and 3.
So we have...
We've got Isaac Hedin starting on the bump, Noah Wallacher behind the dish, Gunnar Kennedy at third, Colton Steberg starting at short, Jack Vierling at second, Butch Lindell over at first. Looks like Tanner Hedin and right, Reed Summer in center, and Mason Torgerson out in left. So we're hoping to get off to a good start here tonight. This is Isaac's first varsity game pitching this year. I know he's been working in the offseason. He's got good movement on his fastball, good movement on his curveball, so hopefully we can find the zone. Pretty windy here today.
Yep. How many games did he start last year?
I don't remember how many he started last year.
Yep.
I coached him as a kid, and by the end of his, by the time he was 14, 15 years old, he was usually right around that 60% strike range, which is what we want.
Yeah.
Usually 60% is when we win games. But he's got longevity. All the girls want Butch has been very key over at first base this year. He's made some big league picks over there off the ground and kept us in our couple of our games here so far.
Yeah.
Hasn't let anything really get by him. So I'm glad to see him back over there.
In the game yesterday at JWP, the Knights came out with a win. What was the final score?
Yeah, it was 15-6. JWP scored all their runs, I think, in the fourth inning. And ours just kind of came in clusters. Van Epp started the game pitching. Colton pitched the middle of it, and Gunnar Kennedy closed it out. Huh. I think they tied the record for school strikeouts in one game, the three pitchers together. So we are underway.
Leading off for the Wolves, first baseman Drew Johnson.
And Drew Johnson is leading off for the Ely Timberwolves.
You can always tell it's the beginning of the season when those shoes are nice and white.
That's right. And the pants.
First pitch is outside from Hedin.
Ooh, must have been just low.
I think so. So 2-0 the count. Memorial Field has held up pretty well over the winter here and looks like it's in great shape.
Ooh.
This is outside, so that's 3-0 now, the count to the leadoff batter.
Sometimes Isaac gets a little rocky start, but he settles in. He'll be solid.
And there's a ball outside, so 4-pitch walk to lead off the game. That's going to bring up shortstop Cade Chittum for the Timberwolves.
I remember playing Ely last year up in the Legion Baseball, and if they've got the catcher they had last year, he had a very good arm.
Ball outside. So Johnson on first, 1-0 to Chittum here. There's a strike. Soft contact to right field.
Get him.
Oh, they almost double up the runner at first. Nice catch by Tanner Hedin out there and right. That's going to bring up the pitcher for the Timberwolves, Drew Marolt.
Drew Marolt with an L.
With an L.
Yep. So we got one out here. Top of the first.
There's a strike on the outside edge. Nadine steps off.
Isaac's very cautious of the runners. Does a good job controlling. Must have been a hair high.
Yeah. The center cut. 1-1's the count.
So the number three batter here, looking for some power.
It's always a sign when the number three batter is also the pitcher. That's probably the athlete of the team.
Probably. So 2-1 count.
There he catches the inside corner.
That's 2-2. There we go.
Nice curveball. Marolt's able to get a piece, stay alive. Count stays at 2-2.
Isaac does have some good movement on his curveball. I caught a few bullpens for him here this last winter, and I can definitely tell I'm too old for that.
Gave your shoulder a workout.
No. Knees and ankles.
Knees and
we got another foul ball.
Well, you know, if your shoulder moves enough, Dan, you don't have to move the knees and ankles much.
I didn't think about, you know, that boys would want to practice their new pitches.
Yeah. There's soft contact to pass the third baseman.
And he beat it out at first. So we've got runners on first and second.
Up to bat, second baseman Elliot
Kennedy
Clemens.
Charged it, but just couldn't quite get there. And by the time it slowly rolled to Steberg, he no chance at first.
Well, slow rollers are tough when you're playing deep.
So pitch runner for the Timberwolves is number 13. Or maybe it's not a pinch runner. They just brought him a jacket.
They just brought him a sweatshirt. He's the pitcher. They're going to keep his arm warm. Try to prevent injury. It's a windy day out here. Wind blowing in.
It brings up Elliot Levins. He's a senior. Nadine starts him off with a strike. So runners on first and second. One out for the Timberwolves. That curveball had a little movement, and he's able to catch the inside corner for a strike. Nice. I'm not so sure I agree, but
looking a little like Greg Maddux painting corners out here. We'll take it.
That one's in the dirt for a ball. It's 1-2 the count.
Noah does a great job blocking too. Isaac is usually a little more confident on the mound when he's got Noah behind the dish.
Yeah. Another shot to shortstop. Oh.
Bobbled by Steberg.
So everyone's safe.
So we've got bases loaded with one out.
Deegan Richards.
It's going to bring up the right fielder, Deegan Richards, another senior for the Ely Timberwolves.
Batting in the five spot. He should have some power to him, too. Let's see if the Knights can flip a double play here.
There's a strike.
And it looks like Isaac has settled in.
Oh, gets him to foul one back. That'll run the count to 0-2. It's nice to jump ahead of a batter when you have the bases loaded like this. A strikeout would go a long way.
Oh, a strikeout would be huge here.
There's another soft contact to the left side. They're coming home with it. Oh, it just bounces past Wallaker. That's going to score two. Kennedy was decisive to come home. The throw just was a little off target. And
yep.
Allows two runs to score.
So the Knights down two here with one out.
Now to bat catcher Ben Leeson.
I think if the throw's on target, he's got him out at home. Yep. He was in plenty of time.
Yep, he had time there.
So that'll bring up Ben Leeson, junior for the Timberwolves.
So we only have a force out at first base now.
Dean's moving into first pitch strike the past few batters.
Yep, I think he's settled in. He's found his spot. He's doing a good job pitching.
Another one to the left side. Kennedy gathers himself, throws cross to first, and they get the out.
So we got two outs.
Nice throw by Genner.
Bat, third baseman Owen Marolt.
So that'll bring up the third baseman, Owen Marolt. He's a freshman. Gathering he might be related to the pitcher.
Yep, he
Drew
is.
Marolt. Fouls that off, out of play. That's why you don't park over there.
Well, hopefully Larry didn't put the grill over there.
I think Larry has the grill hidden. I'm not sure where he's grilling up, but it's not his normal spot. Oop. Oh, and then here, where's one?
That doesn't hurt anything here. That loads him up and makes it easy to get the third out here.
Now batting for the Wolves, designated hitter Xander Luzlegar.
That's going to bring up Xander Lislegard. He's another senior for the Timberwolves. Ball low.
So we've got bases loaded, two outs. Knights down 2-0 here. Top of the first.
Well, there he paints the corner. Nice pitch by Hedin. Run the count to 1-1. There's another nice pitch. He took something off that. Wislegard was way out in front. It's now 1-2 the count.
Isaac's got a good changeup.
There he gets him with the curve, and Walker's able to tag him out. So the Timberwolves score two on how many hits, Dan?
They score two on one, two, three hits.
After half of an inning, it's Ely 2, Knights up to bat. We'll be back after this.
Busby's Hardware and Furniture in downtown Zimbrota is your place to shop for your general hardware needs. They carry the top-of-the-name brands like reliable Milwaukee and DeWalt power tools and beautiful Valspar paint. Their furniture department also offers all types of furniture, lamps, and mattresses, with over three floors of selections to choose from. In need of new appliances? Well, they have that too. They are a proud Whirlpool dealer, and they offer Amana, Maytag, KitchenAid, and Whirlpool appliances from freezers, microwaves, refrigerators, and more. Plus, with their very own delivery truck, Busby's offers delivery of appliances and furniture. Busby's excellent customer service and friendly staff are what separate them from their competitors. So go ahead and shop local and swing on down to Busby's Monday through Saturday, opening at 7:30 a.m.
I'm Bill Miller, and this is RJ. You're watching the Knights on YouTube. Go Knights.
What I really love about Ellington is being family-owned. Everybody knows everybody, and you feel like you're always part of the team.
We've worked Hawaii, Alaska, all over the place.
Seeing something different, hanging with the guys, you really get to know everybody a lot more.
There's always room to grow here. If you want to move up, the opportunities are here.
They do what they say. They say what they do. They strive to do the best. They have a lot of passion.
It was a good fit for me and my family, and I look forward to coming to work every day.
All right, Knights fans, we're back here. So for Ely, we've got Drew Merolt out on the bump. And we've got Ben Leeson catching. We've got Drew Johnson over on first. Elliot Levins on second. Cade Chittum at shortstop. Owen Merolt at third. Outfield, we have Jack Davies, Sam Leeson, and Deegan Richards.
And Reed Summer up for bat for the Knights. Takes a pitch right down the heart of the plate. Must have been an inch high.
Reed's a little short.
We'll take it. That's ball one.
We'll take it.
That one's up two. So 2-0 the count to Summer. You don't see too many green bats.
That is the Louisville Meta, last year's model.
Yeah?
Yeah. They were on sale at Shields this year for $200. It's usually a $450 bat.
Oh.
Seen a lot of them lately.
So cost-effective is, Summer. There's a pitch that looked just like the first one, but that one's a strike, so it counts 2-2.
Reed's a very cautious batter. Usually pretty smart with his pitches.
That one's way outside. That's an impressive reach by the catcher, though. Looks like you taking BP for the kids, I'm guessing, doing the splits like that, Dan?
Yeah, I was not doing splits.
It's a full count to Summer. Oh, he takes one on the inside corner for strike three. turned like he thought it was going to hit him, but
that's what it looked like to me. But must have.
I guess that's an edge. That's a sign you're right on top of the plate.
Yeah. Well, Reed will do that. He'll crowd. Colton had a pretty deep shot yesterday. Not quite over the fence, but.
Ball one to Steberg.
Colton, another very selective person with his pitches. Usually makes the pitcher earn a strikeout if he gets one.
It's ball one.
Ball two.
Ball two?
Ball two.
I'm behind. Yeah, being selective is good as long as you're not letting the strikes run by you. It's high.
Yep, there we go.
Three balls. You give Steberg the green light here, Dan?
Nope, I'd take it.
So did he.
There we go.
It's a four-pitch walk, so that'll get things started for the Knights. Runner on first for Will Van Epps.
Number 34, Will Van Epps.
Van Epps got two home runs on the year already.
Oh.
We got some pretty hard wind coming in, though. I don't know if he'll really have to get a good one, put it out today. But a deep fly. Colton's quick.
Well, it's a little high with the first pitch, so it's 1-0.
One out, you got shortstop in second place playing deep. Colton's pretty quick. I'd look for maybe a steal here.
He stays put. Merolt's able to hit the outside edge. Run the count to 1-1.
Van Epps is a very selective batter also. Smart with his pitches. Patient.
There, they're checking on Steberg. He's back in time. Picked a curveball to steal on and made it safely.
Yep. So we got a stolen base for Colton.
Yeah. That was great. You
catcher
just watched
with a
that
good arm.
You watch that ball just kind of float, 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 float. Yep. He picked the right one to steal on. There's no runner in scoring position for Van Epps. Takes ball three high.
Colton getting a pretty impressive lead out there at second base. Shortstop's now covering. Second base is coming over.
Yeah.
Two of them aren't going to let him get that big again, I don't think.
That's good, though. Draw them in.
Here we go.
Open up some holes. He's outside, so runners on first and second for the Knights now. That's going to bring up Gunnar Kennedy.
Now batting, number 27, Gunnar Kennedy.
He's got old school Kanye for his walk-up music.
Gunner can hit the ball pretty hard too.
Roll checks the lead runner. There's a ball high in the air to shallow center. He's got a beat on, but he drops it. The runners are going to advance. Oh, and there goes Steberg, making him work. Oh, and he is thrown out at the plate. Nice throw from the shortstop. Well, the baseball gods giveth, and they taketh away.
They taketh away. So Gunner reaches on an error there. Van Epps advances to second.
Yeah. Well, you can't fault them, especially when they just drop a ball in center field. Let's make them make a play to get an out, and the shortstop threw a bead.
Yes, he did.
Right on the money.
It was a 9-6-2. Catcher did a good job, gave him his lane. Tried to get a run back.
First pitch is high to Wallaker. He's a junior for the Knights. Pitch outside. Looks like all the Knights are wearing the stirrups this year. Is that the case, or just the first few batters I've seen?
No, not all of them. Butchie doesn't have them.
Oh. It's a nice look.
Old school.
So 3-0 with a count to Wallaker. Oh, and they're going to try to pick off Van Epps, and throw goes in the center. But he was diving back, so didn't have a chance to advance.
Yep, so we've got two outs here. Runner on first and second, bottom of the first.
Guessing Walker's going to be taking this, given there was a four-pitch walk ahead of him not too long ago. Oh, check swing, fouls it back. It was a strike right down the middle.
It was a strike, yep. So he's still favored in the count here, 3-1. Pitcher's still got to come to him.
That one's high. So that'll load the bases again.
Now batting, number six.
It's going to bring up Butch Lindell, senior for the Knights.
We got Kyle Vukolich running bases for Noah Wallaker. Butchie's had a couple of good hard hits this year. Let's hope he can find one here. We can find some green on a deep shot. We can get two runs back, tie it up again.
Good hard
swing. Nobody holding any runners here.
He is looking to hit one into the outfield with that first pitch.
Yep. If you're going to go after it on the first one, go after it.
That one just missed outside. So 1-1's a count. Oh, went back out there. Just missed again.
So we had a 2-1 count for Butch.
He's not missing by much. The ump's been calling that outside edge a little more liberally than the inside.
They say the 2-1 is the most decisive pitch in the MLB, Brent.
It is.
So Butch taking that a strike has now got less than a 20% chance to reach base. Had that been a ball, he'd have had 80%.
So that's where things turn, is what
you're saying. They turn.
Well, I think
now we got to be aggressive.
Oh, there's strike three. So the Knights load up the bases twice, but come up empty. After one, it's the Ely Timberwolves 2, KW nothing. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
The Faribault Hockey Association is excited to sponsor the CAN, and they want you to know there is an opportunity to play hockey for both boys and girls in grades pre-K through ninth grade. They believe that life skills such as teamwork and sportsmanship can be taught through the game of hockey, along with staying mentally and physically fit. If you've heard over the years that hockey is too expensive, well, think again. They offer rental gear, and there are huge discounts for new families. If you are wanting to introduce your child to hockey, simply go to www.faribaulthockey.com, where you can see their pricing and schedules. The association also hosts open skates for families throughout the year at the Faribault Ice Arena, which is located on the fairgrounds next to Bruce Smith Field. Consider registering your child for hockey today.
And we're back. We're top of the second.
So we're leading off here with the bottom of the order, Sam Leeson.
Sam's another senior for the Timberwolves. They've got a very experienced lineup.
Yeah, a lot of seniors.
Leading off for the Wolves in the top of the second, left fielder Sam Leeson.
So Nadine up for his second inning of work. According to your count, he had 30 pitches the first inning?
Close. 27. So did Ely, though. There we go.
Strike one on the inside corner. Just a bit low. So one and one the count. Nice strike on the outside edge. Blustery day here at Memorial Field. Every now and then you get a gust. You hear the...
Coldest on record, I think.
Beautiful pitch. Nice strike three. Slows him down with the curveball. So that's one out.
Now up to bat first baseman Drew Johnson.
Bringing up Drew Johnson for the Timberwolves. He's a sophomore playing first base.
Lefty.
Venture to say that there have been colder games played at Memorial Field. There is no snow coming down.
Right,
so.
Yeah, there is no snow. Beautiful pitch.
Boy, Walker puts his leg out. Is it training the catchers to have one leg out? And
gives them a chance to relax.
Misses with the curveball outside. Runs the count to one and one. Swing and a miss. So two outside. Strikes. Now the count on Johnson. There's another curveball slowly hit back to Hedin. He's going to collect it and throw it to first for the out.
Plenty of time.
So there you go. Two up, two down. It's going to bring up Cade Chittum. Junior shortstop, back to the top of the order.
Second batter.
Chittum flew out to
Tanner Hedin
to right field.
Right field.
The first inning.
Little blooper out there. That's when Tanner almost doubled him up at would have been Drew Johnson at first. Isaac's dusting him back a little there.
If he hits the outside edge. Yep, that was the plan. One and one.
Folded him.
It's hard to reach out over the plate after you just got brushed back a little bit.
Yeah, he's going a little old school Nolan Ryan there.
Missed just low with that one. It's a two and one's a count. Oh, hard shot right back up the middle by Chittum. Summers got it back in. So runner on first for the Timberwolves.
Pitcher Drew Marolt.
And that'll bring up Drew Marolt, senior pitcher. Marolt.
Marolt scored last time, I believe you. He had a hit.
He had a hit.
Yep. I think he was the one that reached on air.
Okay.
Bobbled ball at short.
At short, yep. Oh, this ball gets by Hedin.
Cold fingers. Sometimes you can't feel the ball when you throw it, and it slips out early.
Huh. 0-1's the count on Marolt. There's nice strike spot. Two on the outside edge. I mean, baseball is a game that was meant to be played when it's 70 degrees out. And
especially with today's bats.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, just missed with the curveball. So that brings the count to one and two. Two out.
That was a big league take by the batter, Marolt. With an 0-2 count, I'd have been swinging.
Missed outside. Runs count to 2-2. Gentleman with a good lead off first. There's a hard shot to Steberg. He's able to grab it, go to two for the force, and no damage done. So the Wolves have one hit but score none. After 1.5, it's still Ely 2, the Knights nothing. We'll be back after this.
Are you like me and don't know how to do your own taxes? Well, Gary Bukta, CPA in downtown Kenyon, is staffed and ready to accept new clients. Longtime Kenyon residents Heidi Haugen and Angie Mills work at the firm, along with Gary and his son Jason. And Angela has been assisting Kenyon clients for over 20 years. So stop with the confusion and meet face-to-face with the local tax professionals at Gary Bukta CPA.
I'm Rich Kincaid, and you're watching The Can.
Ken Seifert opened the hair place in 1985, and he's been serving clients in the Kenyon area ever since. His son Dylan joined in 2021, and together they offer hair cutting for men, women, and children, and hot towel shaves for men. They're open Tuesday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 and Saturday from 8 to 3. And walk-ins are always welcome. You can call 507-789-5899 to schedule your next haircut or shave. The Hair Place, lowering your ears for 38 years.
Welcome back to the bottom of the second.
Yeah, Brent, bottom of the second. We've got Jack Vierling, Mason Torgerson, and Tanner Hedin up. Jack is a good contact hitter.
You know what his walk-up song is?
No idea. No? I don't ask such details.
Nice pitch by Marolt on the outside edge. He said he's at close to 30 pitches as well in the first inning.
Yeah, he was at 26.
Ball high. So 1-1 the count to Vierling. There he is. Nice contact. Second baseman's able to run it down. Well, good contact by Vierling, but the second baseman shows off his athleticism, and there's one down for the Knights. That's going to bring up number 11, Mason Torgerson.
Mason's a good pull ball hitter. Usually has some pretty good power.
He's high and outside with the first offering from Marolt. All outsides, 2-0 the count. So there's more games tomorrow. All these teams are playing each other.
I believe Cherry, yes. Cherry and International Falls will be here tomorrow with Ely. I believe Cherry and International Falls are, one of them is playing in JWP, and I think I heard the other one was playing in Hayfield before here in the morning, so.
So they're not having a hard time finding games in the area.
Double hitters for everybody.
That's great. Torgerson looked to drive that one, just missed. Count's now 2-2.
Ooh, close.
Took one outside. Looked really good to me. That's going to run the count full. One out for the Knights. Oh, and he's just ahead of that one. So there's Marolt with his first strikeout of the game. There's two out for the Knights.
That's his third strikeout.
Third strikeout.
Yep, he got Reed and Butchie in the first inning.
Oh.
So we got Tanner Hedin now. Tanner also is a kind of a pull ball hitter and can hit with power.
Strike one. I'm just making stuff up left and right here.
I'm not sharing you the information I got. That's the problem. I could be better.
We don't need confirmation that the memory's not quite there.
Mine's slipping too. It's okay.
Oh, Hedin gets under one. Third baseman looks like he's got a beat on it. And able to put it away. So three up, three down for the Knights in the bottom of the second. After two, score is Ely 2, your Knights 0. We'll be back after this.
Formerly known as Farmer State Bank, Heritage Bank expanded to three locations in 2019 with branches in Denison, West Concord, and Northfield. When you bank at Heritage, rest assured they have a vested interest in you and your community. Being family-owned and operated, they live and work in the communities they serve. The faces you see are committed to meeting your needs and earning your trust. They value their partnership with you. Your family's financial future is as important to them as it is to you, and they are dedicated to providing products and services tailored to meet your needs. Check out heritagebankmn.com to see all that Heritage Bank has to offer.
I'm Siri Kwam, and you're watching The Can.
Holly Burrow grew up on a farm in Lake City, but when she was just 10 years old, her family lost the farm due to the financial crisis in the 1980s. From that point forward, she knew she wanted to find a way to help farmers. She graduated from River Falls with a degree in ag business, and after working numerous jobs in ag production and medical research, she wanted to get into accounting and specialize in farm tax. So, she purchased a building in downtown West Concord and opened her own practice in 2015. She's been assisting her clients in payroll, nonprofit.
Leading off for the Wolves in the top of the third, number 11, Elliot Levins.
So top of the third, Elliot Levins up. Isaac Hedin still out on the bump. Isaac's got about 45 pitches. And delivers a strike.
Took a little off that one. Levins was out in front of it. Tried to paint the inside edge, just missed.
He is doing a good job of trying to hit his corners. He hasn't left too many hanging out over the middle.
There he missed just low.
So we got a 2-1 count here.
That one definitely low. So runs the count to 3-1.
Isaac likes to work fast.
Yeah, I would too.
It's cold.
45 degrees out there. There's a strike.
There we go.
The count's full to Levins. He had to hit his first time up, too?
Levins, yes.
And just missed. Low and inside. So Levins draws a walk. Nobody out. Runner on first for the Wolves. Brings up Deegan Richards, senior. Deegan had to hit his first time up.
Yes.
Hedin checks on the runner. Shows bunt. Oh, and Walker tries to pick him off at first, and he's back in time.
Butch did a good job of getting in front of that and knocking it down.
So Richard showed bunt. Missed. Walker able to snap, throw down to first. Almost got the runner leading a little too much. Hedin had a curveball that did not curve. Missed high. One and one's a count. Shows bunt again. There he puts one down foul.
Two strikes on him now. He shouldn't be bunting again.
The Suns making an appearance at Memorial Field.
Doesn't look like it's going to stay for long. It's too cold.
Kennedy's still playing up. He's a swing and a miss. So there's the first out of the inning. Hitting with how many strikeouts does he have?
That would be his third strikeout.
He has three strikeouts as well. It's going to bring up Ben Leeson, a junior for the Wolves.
Still got a runner on first with one out.
Leeson's showing bunt. He puts down a great one. Hedin there to throw him out. But that moves the runner to second. The Wolves playing small ball. Move the runner into scoring position for number 41, Owen Marolt. Owen, his first time up.
Was hit by a pitch.
Oh, that's right. He's looking to do damage. Just missed one. Fouled it straight back. So 1-1. Given they were bunting the two runners ahead of him, I think Kadeen's got to be careful with this batter.
Well, he's swinging. Yeah. That's huge. 0-2 pitch.
Goes right at him, soft contact foul. Marolt able to hang with that curveball.
Isaac's got a good curveball, good changeup. He'll use both. See if we can get him to ground out here.
Fouls off the low pitch. Still 0-2 with two out. Runner on second. Just ahead of that one.
Well, Isaac's definitely got cold hands, but he's hitting his spot. That's That's eight pitches in a row for strikes.
Yeah. There's the curveball for strike three on the outside edge. So the Wolves get one hit but leave a runner stranded at second. No runs. After 2.5, the score is Ely 2, your Knights 0. We'll be back after this.
JB's Tavern is happy to sponsor the Can again this year. And if you're looking for a good spot with good food to watch the game, JB's Tavern in downtown Wanamingo always has the game on the big screen. They're open Tuesday through Sunday for lunch and dinner, and you can dine in or take out. Scan the QR code now to check out their menu. JB's is offering game day food specials 1 hour before and during all Viking games this season. But that's not all. They're even giving away sports memorabilia during all Vikings games. They gave away a signed Justin Jefferson jersey week one. Entries start 1 hour before kickoff, and the winner will be drawn immediately after the game, and you must be present to win. JB's Tavern, your place to watch the game.
I'm Rudy, and you are watching the Can.
Hey, looking to start a project? Swing on down to Kenyon Ace Hardware, where you will find all your big name brands. Shop their selections of steel equipment, DeWalt and Old Milwaukee power tools, and the Yeti brand. Or maybe you need to freshen up your home with a clean coat of paint. Are you sick of shoveling snow? Stop by to check out their snowblower inventory, including Cub Cadet. Or maybe you are ready to think spring and need some Weber grill accessories or a riding lawnmower. Support Kenyon Ace Hardware today, located on Gunderson Boulevard in downtown Kenyon.
Welcome back. Bottom of the third. Reed Summer up to bat. Reed with some old school late 90s, early 2000 walk-up music.
Top of the order, Reed.
Reed struck out looking the first time.
Great base runner. We need him on.
It's a strike on the outside edge. There, he puts that green bat to use. Fly ball right center. Right fielder drops it. That would have been a tough catch. Good hit by Summer.
Right fielder tracked a long way to get there and hit his glove and popped out.
Yeah.
Everybody clap your hands.
He covered. He's almost in center field. They're playing their center fielder to the left. So he didn't have a chance. We'll get Summer a chance to see if he can steal a base here. Steberg up to bat. Steberg grounded out his first time up. Takes the first pitch strike on the outside edge. Ronald's got a little movement on his pitch there because by the time catcher catches it, it's in the batter's box, but it's catching the front corner. There's Steberg puts one in play.
Let's hope that drops.
Oh, the first baseman just missed it, but it was foul. I'm guessing the wind pushed that a little bit.
Those are tough to get to, yeah. He started out running back and had to come kind of back in towards it.
So that runs the count to 0-2 on Steberg.
Almost had the old little league timeout over there with Reed Summer tying his shoe on first base. Ooh.
Down and low. It's a good place for it when you're up 0-2. See if they'll catch, if they'll
bite
go fishing.
It.
Tries it outside again, misses. So that's 2-2 the count now. Nobody out. Summer's got a little bit of lead, but it doesn't look like he's going to be going on this.
Pitcher's throwing two outside like that. They're worried about Reed running maybe the second.
Steberg, soft contact to the second baseman. But the throw gets by him. Summer going for third. Left fielder with a high throw, so he'll be in. Steberg makes it to second. So the Knights take advantage of at least one error there and are able to...
Yep, that'd be an error on the throw from the second baseman. So second baseman overthrew shortstop, went out to shallow left. Reed advanced all the way to third, first to third. Colton got to second. So we have no runners on first. Steberg on second. Summers on third.
Nobody out.
Nobody out. Van Epps up. So we need a good hard hit here to score two.
I'm guessing this is who you'd want up in this position.
Yep. We got our number 3, 4, and 5 batters coming up. That's the heart of our order.
And pitch missed outside. So 1-0. See if Ely's going to pitch to Van Epps here. My guess is if you've done your homework, you might be around the edges with him and hoping he's chasing. He's low and outside.
Well, he's not one you want to hang over the middle of the plate here.
No.
Plenty of power. If he goes, he can do some damage opposite field. Nobody holding Reed on at third. Well, the third baseman's wandering over.
It was a good curveball. Looked like it was strike, but it must have been a little high. So Van Epps has a 3-0 count now, and they're just going to walk him. I tend to agree with that move.
Yep, that was a smart move by Ely.
That's not what we mess around.
You don't normally see that in high school, I don't think, but.
No, you'd think you'd see more of it with the pitch counts. You know, if you know you're not going to throw to someone, just why waste that pitch? Yeah. So bases loaded with Knights, nobody out, Gunnar Kennedy up.
The whole infield is out on the mound meeting with the pitcher now. Gunnar Kennedy can hit hard. All we really got to do here is hit a deep fly, and Reed can tag. Hopefully Colton can tag from second to get to third and do it again. Mm-hmm. Sacrifice is good here. Hits better.
Yeah. We need a run on the board, though.
Yep.
There's a fly ball. Shallow in the infield. They call it the infield fly? Nope. Shortstop's able to track it down. So that's one out for the Knights.
Got the fly ball. Didn't go where we wanted it.
Number four, Noah Wallacher gets his chance with the bases loaded.
Let's not leave runners on, boys. Let's go. One out and we're loaded.
Ball low and outside.
Back.
Nice job blocking that by the catcher, Leeson.
Catcher's done a good job keeping the ball in front of him here for Ely.
Yeah. I don't think we had one to the backstop all game from either side?
No, we haven't.
There's a pickoff move at second. Steberg's back.
Usually you'll see those guys out on first and second getting bigger leads. Catcher's making some signs. That was a heads-up play by Colton to get back. Ely doing a good job here at controlling runners.
Yeah.
Three of our better base runners are on base.
There's a strike from Merle. So 2-1's the count now to Wallacher. One out with bases loaded.
Ooh.
Swing and a miss.
Noah's going for deep there.
Brings the count to 2-2. Now we need some contact. It's a ball outside.
Now he's got to come to him.
So full count with the bases loaded and one out.
So this is favorable for Noah. 3-2, he's got to throw a strike or he walks a run in here. Noah's got to be ready to unload on one here. Should be a fastball.
It is, and he drives one to left. Left fielder back, able to make the catch. Here comes Summer. Get to the shortstop, he's going to fake a throw. So the Knights get their first run of the day. Nice sacrifice fly by Wallacher. Brings in Summer. Just deep enough. And the shortstop's got an arm. He showed us that earlier.
Yes, he did. So we've got two outs here. Runners on first and second.
Butch Lindell up to bat. Butch struck out his first time up.
Oh,
There's a ball low. Nice dig by the catcher. Base hit here ties up the game. That one's a little high. It's 2-0 with a count on Lindell.
This pitcher's been throwing outside a little bit, and center field's playing over towards the left side. It'd be good to see Butchie go out to right center.
There's a lot of room out there.
Center's playing pretty shallow.
There's a hard shot, but right at the shortstop. Good contact by Lindell, but shortstop's in a good place. So the Knights able to score one on no hits.
We got a sacrifice fly by Noah to get Reed in. Yep.
So after three, the score is 2-1 in favor of Ely. We'll be back after this.
Located on the corner of 2nd Street and Red Wing Avenue, the Kenyon Muni is proud to support Kenny Winnemingo Schools. Did you know that a portion of the Kenyon Muni's profit goes to the city's general fund to help defer costs on other city entities, such as the swimming pool and general maintenance? The Kenyon Muni offers food and beverage 7 days a week. Visit their location in downtown Kenyon to enjoy pizza and appetizers while watching the Knights on the big screen.
Hi, I'm Scott Van Epps. Welcome to the Knights Activities Network.
The Kenyon Veterans Organizations are looking for new members. Grab a friend and stop by the Kenyon VFW to join. It is completely free to join the Color Guard, and they even buy your uniform for you. The Color Guard is a volunteer organization that works around your schedule. So if you're a veteran, consider joining the Color Guard or the American Legion Post 78, the Kenyon VFW Post 141, or the Kenyon Auxiliary. The veterans wish all the Knights teams good luck this season, and they appreciate all the KW students.
Welcome back, Knights fans. Top of the fourth inning. Knights are trailing the Ely Timberwolves 2-1. Isaac Dean is out there for his fourth inning of work, up to 61 pitches.
Be leading off here, top of the fourth.
Up to bat, at the top of
should
the
be
fourth.
Xander Lislegaard.
Xander Lislegaard.
It is Xander Lislegaard.
Yep, DH. Xander's
not a name you hear too often.
No, it's not.
But I like it. Soft contact right to Lindell. He's able to scoop it up and make the first out. So one pitch, one out. That's pretty efficient.
That is efficient.
Up to bat, left fielder
it's
Sam
gonna bring
Leeson.
Up the left fielder, Sam Leeson. He's a senior for the Wolves.
Sam Leeson had a good, ended up striking out, but I think he took Isaac for quite a few pitches that last inning.
Swings and misses for strike one.
I think he had 11 pitches on Isaac last inning.
Fall to the left. Anytime I need someone to do book, I think I'm going to bring Dan with.
I'm not that good, believe me.
Well, if you can keep
my
track,
counts will be slightly off.
If I'm pretty impressed when you can keep track of how many pitches each batter had. There's a soft contact back to Hedin. Underhand toss to Lindell. They get the second out. So two up, two down. That's going to bring up.
Now to bat, first baseman Drew Johnson.
The first baseman, Drew Johnson, sophomore for the Wolves. He's their leadoff batter, is that correct? He walked and scored in the first and grounded out in the second.
Yep.
First pitch is a little low. Hedin. Oh, and Steberg
Just out of the reach of Steberg.
Couldn't quite get it. Johnson picks a nice spot to put it through. He's on first. That brings up their shortstop, Cade Chittum. He's a junior. Chittum flew out to right field in the first inning and then reached on a single in the second. There's soft contact right to Steberg. He's going to have to hurry. He gets the play at second.
There we go.
Nice play by Steberg.
So 6-4 ground out.
Four. The Wolves send four to the plate. Get one hit, but no runs. After 3.5, score is Ely 2, your Knights 1. We'll be back after this.
I am Jeff Wibben, and you're watching The Can.
I don't know about you, but I am not a handyman. Even the most basic jobs, I screw it up. So I've stopped putting unnecessary holes in the wall and instead called a crew at L&M Construction for our interior and exterior home projects. Not only are they terrific craftsmen, the crew is from the area and even have kids in our district. So do yourself
and your home
a favor and call the crew at L&M Construction for your next home project.
Please.
Lifelong Wealth Advisors is a comprehensive financial planning firm that works with individuals and families to help provide clarity and purpose around their financial planning future. We've structured our entire business around advocating for our clients' best interests.
Their input is really important. And I always tell clients, I don't want this to be my vision of what you think you should do. We need your feedback in terms of what's important, what your goals are, what your objectives, what you're passionate about, and come up with that plan together.
Truly the best part of this business is sitting across from a client and just writing out their goals, their hopes, what they want with the future. Because money is a tool to buy things, to buy time, and it's part of what...
Now batting, number 2, Jack Beerley.
Welcome back. Bottom of the 4th, Jack Beerling up to bat. He's got the green bat now, ready to do
some
damage.
There's lots of green bats out there, I'm telling you.
Oh, right up the middle, center fielder, able to put it away.
Ugh.
So one pitch, one out for the Knights. It's going to bring up Mason Torgerson.
I like it when the batters are aggressive on that first pitch. The pitcher always wants to get ahead in the count. They're always going to go for that 0-1. You're going to get something good right away. Might as well go for it.
Yeah. Well, Beerling had good contact. You know, if the center fielder isn't playing that shallow, which somebody's got to, until you...
They can get those line drives when they're like that, yep.
Until you can burn them a little bit and make them pay for playing that shallow.
We got wind blowing in here, too.
There's a pop-up.
That's out.
Looks like it's out of play. So counts 1-1 to Torgerson. Maroltz close to 60 pitches now.
Yep, Maroltz at 6. This will be 62.
This looked like he was trying to do a curveball. It did not curve. Torgerson didn't flinch much. I thought he should.
We got that west wind cutting across here, so if you don't have enough spin, that's not going to move much.
There's another one inside. Runs count to 3-1.
There we go.
Pitch is high, so Torgerson draws a walk. We have one out, runner on first for Tanner Hedin.
Number 21, Tanner
Hedin. Tanner flew out to
third base.
Baseman, yep. First time up.
Just outside the foul line.
Torgerson with his lead on first. He's going. There's a hard throw that's drifting. It hits Torgerson.
In the old days, he'd have been out.
Yeah.
Kind of like dodgeball.
That was actually kind of unfortunate for the Knights, because if that doesn't hit him, I think that's off in the,
yeah,
in the outfield, and he's on to third.
Yep.
So good jump by Torgerson. Catcher Leeson's got a good arm, but that one was just drifting on him. Hedin with...
That a boy, Torgy.
Contact, throw it first, is able to get Tanner.
So we got a 5-3 out there.
So that's two outs for the Knights.
Number one, Reed Summer.
Back to the top of the order with Reed Summer. Reed struck out in the first, reached on a
error
in the third, and came around to score the Knights' only run.
Yep. Two outs here. Hopefully he can get a hit and get Torgy in. There we go.
Hard shot down the line, just foul.
A little ahead of that one.
Summer shaking his head.
He wants that one back.
He was all over it, just pulled it a little too much. Lays off a high fastball. Brings the count to 1-1.
Torgy's got a good lead at third. Ooh.
Oh.
Ooh.
You could see the ump having a conversation with himself. He thought no, then thought maybe, and then shook his head no. It's outside, and I'm guessing a little low.
Yeah.
Well, that one, Reed, that's the second time he's turned like he's going to get hit and got a strike called on him. You got to know if you're crowding the plate, that inside pitch.
Reed knows. Reed's very smart player.
There's the ball outside. Full count.
This still could be anything. Nothing really hurt here. They got two outs. If Reed walks, it helps them.
There, Reed calls time. So full count, two outs for Summer. Runner on third. Base hit ties the game. There he fights one off.
Ah.
But first baseman's able to catch it.
Reminder, baseball fans, if you're starting
so
to pull out there,
Knights get a runner on, move him to third, but aren't able to bring him in. So no runs after four complete. Score is Ely 2, KW 1. We'll be back after this.
At Midwest Machinery Company, we strive to equip and support the agricultural, consumer, and commercial markets of Minnesota and Wisconsin. We are a growing team of dedicated individuals who care about the markets we serve and the quality of support we provide. In everything we do, we strive to maintain that local dealership feel that our customers know and depend on. For more information about Midwest Machinery, to see a full list of our new and used equipment, or to see our current career openings, visit our website at mmcjd.com.
I'm Blair Reynolds.
And you're watching The Can!
Since opening their doors for business back in 2012, Minnesota Wi-Fi has been associated with a high level of quality and professionalism. That's largely because of their concerted effort to deepen their connections they have within our local communities and to continuously improve their services they provide. Minnesota Wi-Fi would like to thank their loyal customers, and if you are looking for an affordable and reliable internet provider, contact Minnesota Wi-Fi at 507-634-9434 or go to mnwifi.com for more information.
Hey, Knights Nation, we're back here on the can. We've got number 13, Drew Marolt, pitcher, batting. Isaac Hedin delivers, first pitch ball.
Just a little high. Hedin did a great job. He started that last inning at near 60 pitches, ended it with 67, so able to get another inning or two out of him.
See how the old rubber arm holds up. Counts 2-0 here. Nice. Ooh, I thought that was inside. Inside corner. Ump didn't give it to him. 3-0. And ball four.
So Marolt's able to draw a four-pitch walk.
Up to bat for the Wolves, number 11, Elliot Levins.
I won't make the same mistake I made in the first. They're just bringing the pitcher his jacket to keep him warm.
That's key against injuries.
I wonder who gets that job and how they determine that. You're the all-time jacket runner.
Probably when you're not handing out water.
So that's going to bring up number 11. Elliot Levins for the Wolves. Levins has reached both times up, once with a hit and once with a walk.
Looks like he's squaring around the bunt. Kind of odd for a third batter spot.
He's the cleanup, isn't he?
Number three batter? Number four batter. Sorry, yeah.
There's a swing and a miss. Hedin did a great job pulling the string on that one. Levin's way out in front. So 0-2 the count. Runner on first, nobody out. Just misses outside with a curveball.
Ooh, got him to chase.
Levin's able to get a piece of it, stay alive. Bad boy doing a great job running down those foul balls. That's how Kirby makes sure he never has to run anyone a jacket.
Right.
Inside there corner for strike three. Levin's doesn't like it, but that was painted on the inside.
Fielder Deegan Richards.
So one out for the Wolves. That's going to bring their right fielder, Deegan Richards, a senior. Richards reached on a hit in the first and struck out in the third. He's going to lay down a beautiful bunt. Walker able to throw him out at first. That was a great bunt by Richards.
Catcher Ben Leeson.
So two out now. That's going to bring up the catcher, Ben Leeson. That's the second time they've bunted with one out. So they're keen on getting a runner in scoring position regardless of how many outs there are. Leeson tried to stay back on it, couldn't. There's a nice
outside corner.
Nice pitch on the outside by Hedin.
Oh,
Oh.
Nothing hurt there.
Tried to paint the inside corner, caught Leeson right on top of the helmet.
For the Wolves, third baseman Owen
so
Monroe.
He'll be at first. Runners on first and second for number 41, Owen Marolt, freshman. Owen reached on a hit-by-pitch in the first and struck out in the third.
Looked like Kirby was giving instructions on how to get hit by a pitch there for a second.
He was arguing that the pitch was in the strike zone, but
yeah,
that's a tough argument when it hits the batter in the head.
Yeah, yeah. I agree. There we go, Isaac.
Good swing and a miss. Nice pitch by Hedin. I mean, if you get hit on the thigh, I could see
you
leaned it over, but...
Play a little farm school ball.
So Hedin with two curveballs, two swings and misses by Marolt. Quickly 0-2 with two out. Oh, Marolt's just ahead of that one. Fouls it down the third baseline.
Still 0-2. Runners on first and second. Two outs.
Hedin steps off, check on the runner at second.
Putting his hand in his pocket. He's looking for a little Vaseline to get a little extra stick on the ball there, Brent.
I think he's got some sandpaper back there. To
there we go.
Strike three
got
on the
corner.
Outside corner. Great, great job pitching out of that jam by Hedin. So no runs for the Wolves after 4.5. The score is Ely 2, Knights 1. We'll be back after this.
Plymouth, built to exacting standards. Built for punishment. Day in, day out. Whatever the world dishes out. Performance tested until it's people ready. Keeping every joint, every leg, every surface tough. Plymouth, ingeniously solving problems. Dedicated to delivering the product you need where and when you need it. Balancing design, function, durability, and value. Every kind of client, spanning dozens of industries and applications. Built with pride. Pride in craft. Pride in employee ownership. Pride in a product that people around the world have relied on every day for over 70 years. All built right here in the USA. Plymold. Quality in everything we do.
Welcome back, Knights Nation. We've got Colton Steberg leading off here in the fifth.
Colton grounded out in the first. Oh, hard shot to short. He's got a cannon and throws him out. Good play by the shortstop. I thought Steberg would reach. So that's one out for the Knights.
Going
to bring up Van Epps. Van Epps reached on a single in the first and was walked.
Two walks.
He walked in the first. Yep. So walked in the first, walked in the third. Let's see if they give him something to swing at.
Intentionally walked.
On.
Intentionally walked in the third.
There's a strike on the inside corner. So 0-1 to Van Epps. Marolt steps off.
Kirby's offering visions of warmth in the dugout talking about Bermuda.
outside. So 1-1 the count to Van Epps. There's a shot down the right field line. Foul. Oh.
Just foul.
So that'll bring the count to 1-2 with one out.
If that would have dropped on the line, that would have had, we'd have had double written all over it.
Yeah. There, he scores one up down the hole. Shortstop's got it from his back foot, fires, and throws him out.
Nice scoop by the first baseman there.
Great play all around by the Timberwolves.
That shortstop from deep short had a good arm there.
Yeah, Cade Chittum Jr. making a couple of great plays this inning.
Definitely representing the Ely Timberwolves.
So bring up Gunnar Kennedy. Kennedy reached on a hit in the first and flew out.
Shortstop in the third. Nice curveball.
Nice pitch by Merolt. Started off the inside corner and ended up right over the heart of the plate. That one's low and outside, so 1-1 the count to Kennedy. Lots of options. Nobody on base. Two out. Ball low and outside. Time to get something started.
There you go, 3-1.
A walk would be okay, too.
Yeah, just need runners. Need runners.
Wise man said it doesn't really matter how you get to first base, as long as you get to first base.
Yeah. Was that Yogi Berra?
I don't know if that was. Oh, there's a check swing foul. I don't know if Yogi's credited with many wise things. He's credited with many things.
he had Yogi-isms.
Yes. Yeah, when you get to the fork in the road, you take it.
Yeah.
It's the only one that comes off the top of my head.
There we go.
Kennedy draws a walk. That'll bring up, based on the lineup music alone, I can tell it's Noah Wallacher.
Noah Wallacher. The legend.
Some old school Kanye as well. So Wallacher reached in the first.
Yeah, sacrifice fly, I believe, that scored Reed Summer.
So he's got the only RBI of the day for the Knights. Kennedy takes the lead off first. Merolt checking him.
Score is still 2-1.
Straight up. Leeson takes a look, and he's got it. Puts it away.
It's a good play by the catcher.
It's a nice play by the Ely all around for all three outs that inning. After five full, they still lead your Knights 2-1. We'll be back after this.
I'm Cheryl Dahl, and you're watching the Knights Activities Network.
Revlon Alignment is happy to sponsor the Can again this year. Through quality service and honesty, Revlon Alignment has built a reputation as one of the area's most reliable alignment and auto shops in southern Minnesota. They have the experience needed to help you with all your auto repair and tire needs. And now, their new heavy-duty alignment bay is ready to service any semi or heavy-duty truck needs that you may have. Call 507-824-2710 or visit their website at RevlonAlignment.com to schedule an appointment today. Revlon Alignment, getting you back on the road since 1981.
hope that's not my tire.
No. No. Oh, no.
When your vehicle lets you down, trust the mechanics at River Road Repair to get your day back on track. River Road Repair is a full-service auto shop located on Highway 60, just west of Wanamingo. So whether your car won't start or it just needs a little TLC, call the pros at River Road Repair to schedule an appointment today.
Welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. Ely leads 2-1. New pitcher for the Knights is senior Mason Torgerson, making his 2024 debut from the mound.
I believe this is his first time pitching on the mound here as a senior. Isaac Hedin went somewhere around 85 pitches, give or take a few. Had about a 60% strike average, which is what we want. Usually that means a win for us.
Two runs over five innings, that's not a bad day's work, especially on five hits.
Yep.
It's about a hit an inning. So up for the Wolves is Xander Lislegard.
Lislegard, yep.
Senior.
We got, what, 1-1 count.
And Torgerson looks like he had a little right-to-left movement on that pitch. This little guard fouls one out, so 1-2 the count.
One ball, two strikes, nobody on, nobody out.
Torgerson bounces one. That's going to bring it to 2-2. Looks like he features mostly junk in terms of what he's throwing. Soft stuff that's moving all over.
He's not a hard thrower. But he's got, I think he's got a good changeup, and he's got some movement on his curveball. We'll see how it fares in the wind here.
Oh. Well, you don't see too many people with pitches that move right to left. That one missed just a little high. So Lislegard draws a walk. The Wolves have their leadoff batter on. That's going to bring up number 12, Sam Leeson, senior outfielder.
Number one is running for the DH. So that is Jack Davies, the center fielder.
So Leeson struck out in the second and grounded out to the pitcher in the fourth.
Showing bunt.
And that one gets by Wallaker just a little bit. That's going to allow Davies to reach second. So runner at second, nobody out.
See if he shows bunt here again.
That one just a bit outside. 2-0 the count on Leeson. There, Torgerson threw a fastball. I think that's the first fastball I've seen him throw. There's a curve that's bunted. Oh!
Not sure what happened there.
Throw got by Vierling, kind of right into the runner, and that's going to score a run for Ely. Yeah, so Lindell was covering for the bunt, so he's playing in. So second baseman Vierling has to go over and cover.
He was there. I'm not sure if the throw was off or if the
throw
runner
was just,
interfered. But
the throw was a little offline, kind of brought him right into the runner. Which that one's not the runner's, nothing the runner can do. He's running down the baseline. They're bunting again. Same motion. This time they're able to get the out at first. They move the runner to third. So Leeson's at third. One out.
Now batting for Ely, number four, Cade Chittum.
That's going to bring up Cade Chittum, shortstop for the Wolves. Chittum has flew out to right field, reached on a single in the second, and then grounded out to short in the fourth. Ooh. Nice pitch by Torgerson, just a little high. So 1-0 the count, one out, runner on third for Ely. Just a little high again. 2-0 the count. That one's a bit higher. So 3-0 the count now. That one gets by Torgerson. Third base runner wasn't paying attention, though. So 3-1 the score in favor of Ely. Chittum way back in the box now. Takes a strike on the inside corner.
Counts 3-1.
I'm not sure what Chittum was doing there. Why you? If you're going to take one, don't make it look like you're taking one. There he reaches, grounds one to short. Steberg's there, Rook's the runner back, able to fire and throw Chisholm out at first. So great play by Steberg. That brings it to two outs.
13, Drew Marolt.
Let's bring up the pitcher, Drew Marolt. Marolt singled and scored in the first, grounded out to short in the second, and he drew a walk in the fifth. Swings and miss at the first offering from Torgerson. So 0-1 the count, two out, runner on third. Torgerson just a little high. It's about the third or fourth pitch that's been center cut and maybe an inch too high.
There we go.
Swings and misses, so he's out in front of it. So 1-2 the count. There he lifts one to left field. Hedin had to run back. Oh, and it's over his head. Able to fire it in. They may have a shot at him at second, but ball gets by Steberg. So, Hedin not able to track it down.
That brings in Leeson for another run. Nates are down 4-1.
For Ely, number 11, Elliot Levins.
Good strong contact by Marolt. It's going to bring up Elliot Levins with the runner on second. Now they pitcher. Do bring in a pitch runner for the pitcher.
That's the catcher.
Oh, that's the catcher.
I believe.
No, that's the pitcher.
Nope, that's pitcher. Marolt. Yep, that's Marolt.
So pitch running for the Wolves.
Can't see his number. Three? No.
That was 19. Blake Schaller. He's a junior. Torgerson with his first pitch strike to Levins. Second pitch, soft up the middle, and Vierling's there to put it away. So the Ely's able to score two runs on, I don't think, any hits, right? They had a walk and a couple errors. After five and a half, the score is the Ely 4, your Knights 1. We'll be back after this.
I'm Claire Larson, and you're watching the Knights Activity Network.
Blue sky, I've got that sunshine.
like the birds that fly. Ooh, singing their sweet songs like nothing could be wrong. They've got it right, no worries in sight.
Whether you want to relax or play, Riverview Retreats has your place to stay.
It don't get better than this. No, it don't get better than this. It don't get better than this. No, it don't get better than this. Before the night's through, I wanna.
Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth.
Number six, Butch Lindell.
Butch Lindell up for the Knights. Marolt out for his sixth inning of work. He's up to 84 pitches. Lindell struck out in the first and flew out to the shortstop in the third.
Butchie's a big Star Wars fan.
Contact third baseman, gobbles him up a bit, able to fire, but Lindell beats it out. Good hustle by Lindell. So we got a runner on first. Old school Star Wars? New school Star Wars?
He's all school.
All school Star Wars?
He's all school.
Number two, Jack Vierling.
Brings up Jack Vierling. Vierling.
Jack also a big Star Wars fan. Him and Butch keep talking about doing a Star Wars marathon.
Oh.
They haven't done it yet, though. Well, they're both upset that prom is on May the 4th. Be with you.
At this point, a Star Wars marathon would run like 3 days long, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I'd have to stock up on some frozen pizzas.
Hits at the second base. Oh. Throws in the dirt. Lindell's going to stay put, though. We'll take that. So the force at second. Second baseman throws it away. Everyone's safe, so the Knights have nobody
cold fingers,
out.
Cold fingers.
Yeah. I don't think there's a harder sport to play than baseball in cold weather.
Oh.
So runners on first and second for the Knights. That's going to bring up Mason Torgerson. Torgerson struck out in the second.
Walked in the fourth.
Stole a base. Shows bunt and pulls it back. So first pitch is a ball.
He's been a little cold at bat here lately, but hopefully he gets hot. He hit the ball pretty hard last year by the end of the season, and he could certainly use a hit here.
Ball high.
He has had some successful bunting in the past year, though, too.
Yeah.
If we can move up runners by doing that, too, that helps. Kirby loves this small ball.
There's ball three. Yeah. Well, down by three. Two runners on. At this point, I don't think you're going to be bunting, though, with 3-0. There's ball. Oh, ooh. The strike. Inside corner. So 3-1 the count. There he offered. That's 3-2, so now it counts full.
Now he's going to be swinging.
So Knights trailing by three. Nobody out, runners on first and second. There's a pitch outside. Good eye by Torgerson, so that's going to load him up. For Tanner Hedin. Tanner flew out to the third baseman in the second and grounded to the third baseman in the fourth.
I'm guessing there will be a pitch change here.
Yeah.
This pitcher's up to around 90 to 95 pitches here.
Yeah, with bases loaded, nobody out.
Yep.
I think so. Well, why don't we take a word from our sponsors while they're working on getting a new pitcher in? We'll be back with bases loaded in just a little bit.
Has your roof seen better days? Well, Runnigan Roofing is here to help. Whether you prefer asphalt or steel, Runnigan Roofing utilizes the latest in modern roofing methods to make sure you stay cozy warm in the winter and dry throughout the year. From start to finish, most roofs can be replaced in one day. That's right, one day. And they prepare your property for damage prevention by covering shrubs and plants in your siding with tarps. Call 507-281-8899.
We're back. So they didn't do a pitching change. They just talked for a long time. First pitch is high, which surprised me a little bit because Merolt's at, what, 90-some?
He's up in the 90s, yep.
So Hedin will have his chance. That one would have hit him if he hadn't ducked. And he's hitting his head thinking, why did I duck?
He knows it. That would have scored a run.
Yeah. All right, 2-0. Tanner wanted to do a little more damage. I think he wanted to put one in the outfield.
Yeah.
Oh, and that was a little high. So 3-0 the count. Ely fans don't agree. I might be with them. That looked pretty good. But Tanner
showing bunt here.
Tanner
now
shows bunt. That one's a strike. So 3-1. Merolt's still throwing hard after 90-some pitches.
Nobody's holding anybody on at third here either, which he can get a good lead. There we go.
Hedin with contact to the shortstop. He's going to go to second for the first one. They've got no chance for Hedin down at first, though. So that'll score a run.
Well, that score is Butch.
So good job by Hedin getting contact.
Jack moves to third. Reed is out.
Now batting number one.
Well, Mason was out. Reed's up. So Reed Summers.
Mason, sorry, Morgan Mason, yep.
So Reed's got runners on first and third. One out. Knights down by
fielder's
two.
Choice.
Reed struck out in the first. Reached on an error in the third. There he dribbles one foul. Came around to score and then flew out to the first baseman in the fourth.
Did Reed try to bunt there?
I'm not sure. I was looking at your scorebook trying to see.
That's what I was trying to catch up to. It looked like maybe we were trying to squeeze Veerling in on that one.
There he's swinging. Pop fly just over the second baseman's head. Right fielder makes the catch. Here comes Torgerson scores, or Jack Veerling scores. So that brings the Knights within one. Two productive at-bats in a row from Hedin and Summer.
Now batting number 15, Colton.
So now Hedin's on first, two out, with Colton Steberg at the plate. Steberg grounded out in the first, reached on an error in the third, grounded out in the fifth. Shows bunt, pitches high. Throw down from the catcher is off target. Hedin's in there for a stolen base.
This pitcher's got to be close to his 105 pitch count. I have not done a very good job of keeping track of him here this inning. There's been a lot going on, but.
Hedin with a healthy lead off second. Steber watches one outside. So 2-0. Base hit ties the game here. There's a strike on the outside edge.
So 2-1 count on Colton Steberg.
That one's high. 3-1's count. almost hit Steberg. So he gets a five-pitch walk. He'll take his base. That'll bring up Will Van Epps. Runners on first and second, two out. Van Epps walked in the first, walked intentionally in the third, and grounded out to short in the fifth.
Yep. Ely's got a good shortstop here. He's got a good arm, so let's not hit it back that way.
No. Chittum's pretty much gobbled up everything that's came his way. Hard pitch outside. Runners are going to move.
Tanner's out. Nope, he got in.
Hedin.
There. No!
Hedin's out at third.
Oh, terrible call. He was under that.
Wow. Well, so the Knights threatened, and they scored two, but leave runners on two runners on base. After six full, getting a little closer, Ely's ahead 4-3. We'll be back after this.
I'm Gus Bakken, and you're watching The Can.
The Security State Bank of Kenyon has been serving Southeast Minnesota since 1934, offering convenience banking, account services, lending services, insurance, online banking, and an easy drive-through ATM. So come to the Security State Bank of Kenyon in downtown Kenyon for great service. We hope to see you there.
Welcome back to Memorial Field, where Rudy's delighting the fans with Once Bitten, Twice Shy by Great White. So if you're listening at home, you see all the fun you're missing. Knights get back in the ball game, just down by one. Torgerson out for his second inning of pitching. And 21, Deegan Richards, senior for the Wolves, is leading off. First pitch is low. Richards reached in the first on a hit, struck out in the third, grounded out in the fifth, and flew out in the sixth.
Well, he wasn't up in the sixth.
Not up in the sixth. Who am I looking at?
I'm off.
Oh, you're off. After I gave you like all I those said. Compliments about your book, Dan.
I know. There's a lot to keep track of.
2-0 is the count. Oh, Richards swinging for the fences on that one. Got a piece. 2-1 now the count. Nobody out. There's a swing and a miss. Torgerson pulled the string on that, took something off of it, had Richards way out in front. It's a count to 2-2. Pop up right at the mound. Torgerson says he has it, and he does. So he'll do it himself. That's one out for the Knights. It's going to bring up the catcher, junior Ben Leeson. Leeson on the day, grounded out in the first, had a sacrifice bunt in the third, and hit by pitch in the fifth. First offering from Torgerson's outside. So 1-0 to Leeson.
Yeah.
That one's over his head.
That looked like a Mariano Rivera cutter there, coming back at him.
That's what you call junk that doesn't move. Torgerson wanted that one to move somewhere, and it just kind of came out of his hand awkward. That one moved. So 2-1 the count.
Ooh.
That one was close
too. Just outside. 3-1. Strike three.
Oh, ooh. Gave him a little high. So if he was a knight, we would have said that was a great eye.
Yeah, that's right.
draws a walk down to first base.
Ely, number 41, Owen Marolt.
That's going to bring up freshman Owen Marolt for Ely. Marolt has hit by a pitch in the first, struck out in the third and the fifth. But he hasn't been cheated on his strikeouts. He's been swinging for the fences when he's up there.
Little eye.
All the experience on the team with him being a freshman, my guess is he's aggressive, and when he does get a hold of it, it moves.
Got some good size to him for a freshman.
Yeah. So one out, runner on first for the Wolves. Nice pitch by Torgerson. And Marolt out in front of it. There's another nice pitch out to Hedin. He's right there. Makes
good
the play.
Good job by Tanner there.
Yeah. Took a step in, step to the right, step to the left, caught it.
Yeah. So that's two outs.
Calmly threw it in.
Now to bat number one, Jack Davies.
That'll bring up Jack Davies for the Wolves. This is Jack's first at bat. He came in for Xander Lislegaard.
Xander was the DH.
So Jack's also a sophomore.
Jack's been starting. He's been playing center field here the whole game.
Oh, he has. Has he been hitting, though?
Nope. He's been he was getting DH'd for, and then last inning when Xander got on first base, he came out and ran for him. So my guess is Xander's probably done. Jack will be batting the rest of the game. Ball got stuck in Noah's glove.
So Wolves able to steal a base, get a runner in scoring position. 1-2 count, with two out. Pitches outside from Torgerson, so 2-2 the count. Just a bit low. So runs the count full. There's strike three on the outside edge.
Nice pitch.
So good work by Torgerson getting out of the inning.
Now we got a doer.
So after 6.5, Ely leads by one. Knights up to bat with their last chance after this.
Security State Bank in downtown Wanamingo is your one-shop stop for all your financial needs. SSB of Wanamingo has been here for our surrounding community members since 1918 and continues to offer its customer and future customers with new and innovative services. Stop in or drive through next time you're in town.
I'm Hannah Johnson, and you're watching the Knights Activity Network.
Yeah, but he throws good.
It's bringing power to the dugouts, lighting up scoreboards, or running conduit to the Veterans Memorial, we have put our trust in Shane Electric. Shane Electric has been helping our fields for over 20 years, and we can count on them to provide quality electrical work in a timely manner. And they can do the same for you and your home or business. Call Scott at 507-824-2191 for all your electrical needs. And thank you, Scott and Tom, for all you've done for our fields.
Welcome back, Knights fans. Bottom of the seventh, last chance for the Knights, and they get to face a new pitcher. On the bump for Ely is Cade Chittum. Been playing shortstop all game.
Got a good arm.
Comes in to try to shut it down for the Timberwolves. This should be an exciting matchup because he'll get to face Will Van Epps for the first at bat. So,
yep.
It only takes one swing, is what they say.
That's what they say. Let's hope we can put together a couple of runs here.
There's one good hit. Out to right center. That's past the center fielder. Van Epps thinks about it, but thinks better, turns back. So a good solid hit by Van Epps. It's going to bring up Gunnar Kennedy.
Now batting.
That's what you need, leadoff runner on. Nobody out.
Yes, we do. And Van Epps has got some deceptive speed.
Kennedy's had a good day at the plate. He's been on base twice. Flew out once to short. Shows bunt. Ball's a little high out of the catcher's mitt. Now we got tying run in scoring position.
There we go.
Tough luck for Leeson. He popped up to throw, and ball just kind of hopped right out of his mitt.
Ball hopped right out of his glove.
So 1-0 the count on Kennedy. See if he's bunting still. He shows bunt again. Offers and misses. Chittum checks the runner at second.
1-1's the count.
Shows bunt again, takes a strike on the outside edge. So there's a lot of room up the middle with them holding Van Epps on. There's a ball outside. Good eye by Kennedy.
Gunner's a good batter. Very disciplined.
So 2-2 the count. Nobody out. Tying runs on second. Kennedy gets one he can handle. Fouls it just back. Missed it by that much. Good swing by Kennedy. Do it again. There he does, right to the third baseman, under his glove. Nobody's there, so Van Epps will take third. Kennedy's to first.
So Gunner reaches on an error.
Nice play by Kennedy. Oh, that was hard hit. I suppose that probably was an error.
Error on the third baseman.
Now batting number four.
Hit the ball well. Hit it hard.
Yep.
We need Noah to get one in here. We need to find some green.
And real smart base running by Van Epps when he realized the third baseman was occupied with the ball. It was a foot race between him and, you know, no one's going to get to the bag. I can just advance. So now fly ball in the outfield likely ties the game.
This will be interesting. Typically with the first and third situation, you'll try to have that first guy on first base steal. Gunner doesn't have a lot of speed, but he would be the game-winning run to get to second. So it'd be interesting to watch, see if Ely tries to throw him out if he goes at risk of tying the game with Van Epps at third. Oh, they did switch him out for a different runner. Looks like Kyle Vukolich. So they will probably put on a steal.
Wallaker says, how about I just drive one in the outfield and end the game the old-fashioned way?
And that would be great.
Just missed
it.
Is
that Kyle Vukolich at first?
I'm trying to see the number.
I'm not sure who that is.
Well, the good news is, Dan, on the stream, they probably can't tell either. So as long as we say authority.
Yeah. we could try to zoom in with the camera, but looks like number five.
Yeah, that would be Kyle Vukolich.
Okay.
Oh, Walker swinging for the fences. Coming up short. 0-2 the count.
Just got to find it here, Noah.
So runners on the corners. Knights down by one. Nobody out. Vukolich with the lead on first. The ball's outside and in the dirt.
Good block by the catcher, Leeson.
It was a great block. I mean, if you're going, I think that's the time you're going.
It was close to halfway into the batter's box on the right field side.
Counts 1-2 to Wallaker.
Surprised Kyle didn't go on that.
Oh, there it is. Wallaker's shot down third. Third baseman gathers it but can't get him in time.
Noah's safe. Ooh,
Vukolich
Kyle falls.
Is going to go. He's caught.
Safe.
Oh, no. Ump calls him out at second.
So Van Epp scores.
Wallaker able to tie the game with a hard shot to third. Now that I would call a base hit, right?
That's a base hit. That's a good hard hit.
Fortunately, Vukolich fell down running to third. Caught in Gnomes Man's Land. Tried to get back to second. Looked like he might have been in there, but it was real close play. Ump called him out at second. So that's your first out of the inning. Knights now have the go-ahead run on first. And Butch Lindell up.
Yep, Kyle, someone got pickled there.
Lindell just under it. And it lands on top of the crow's nest. And we're thankful for a good roof. So Lindell came around and scored in the sixth.
Reached down an error.
Oop. They're going. That's called strike.
Had a pitch out.
Pitches out.
Ooh,
there.
He gave us one.
We'll take it.
We'll take that.
It was close. And the manager from Ely's upset, and Kirby's saying,
Pitcher's upset.
Don't even talk to me.
Yeah.
There have been three close plays, and they could have gone either way.
That's a stolen base for Noah.
So now the winning run is in scoring position. One out. Lindell's in the hole, though, 0-2.
We call that a makeup call. Come on, Butchie. Ooh.
Yeah, there's a hard ball right down the middle. Had a little late break down to it. Froze Lindell. So that's the second out of the inning. Brings up Jack Vierling.
Can Jack drive him in?
Vierling reached on an error as well in the sixth and came around to score.
Flew out to center. Flew out to second base.
Here we go. Two outs, runner in scoring position. Base hit wins the game for Vierling. There's a strike on the outside corner. Walker's got good speed at second. Make contact, but fouls it off. So Veerling in the hole, 0-2. Winning run on second, two out. Veerling stays alive.
Get
foul
out,
ball.
Get out.
First baseman had a long run, almost made the play, but.
Foul to the fence. Needs to get another piece to stay alive here. We're 0-2, two out. Base hit to the outfield should score Wallaker.
Chittum shaking his catcher off. He's got a pitch he likes now. Outside. So 1-2 the count.
Shortstop sneaking behind Noah. Coming.
There's a strike three on the outside edge. But the Knights get their run to tie it up. So we get bonus baseball at Memorial Field on a Friday night.
Yes, we do.
We will be back after this.
Meet Jim Swigum, a 1971 Kenyon High School graduate. He went on to study math and teaching at Augsburg University, where he played football and baseball. He was later inducted into the Augsburg Hall of Fame in 1996, and in 2015, he was inducted into the Kenyon Wanamingo Athletic Hall of Fame. For Hall of Fame level insurance, contact the Hall of Famer himself, or stop on by the office and meet his new partner, Adam Dickey. Swigum Insurance Agency. Get the Jimmy Swigum great rate.
I'm Jill Paulson, and you're watching The Can.
In 2022, the Kish family from Wanamingo started Wanamingo Auto Sales that buys, sells, and trades used cars. They average 10 to 15 cars sold a month, and they'll be expanding in the near future to offer more cars on the lot. And they're getting ready to launch their own website. Check out their inventory by swinging down to their location in downtown Wanamingo, or call 507-735-8908 for more information.
If you're looking for a great deal to buy or sell your car, get down to Wanamingo Auto Sales.
Welcome back to Memorial Field. What's better than bonus baseball in April? All the parents are huddled under blankets wondering why they couldn't go home. But at least it's not snowing.
Number 12, Sam Leeson.
So Torgerson in for his third inning of work. First pitch is low ball. Sam Leeson. Senior for the Wolves is up to bat. Leeson struck out in the second. Grounded out in the fifth. And
bunt.
Reached on a bunt and came around to score.
That was one I believe that was overthrown at first. Let's get this first out here. That'd be great.
There's a strike on the inside corner. Torgerson ahead, 1-2 on the count.
Well, let's see that filthy cutter. Nope, throws a curveball.
Missed outside. There's a good pitch. Dribbled down the first baseline, but foul.
That always makes me nervous when they get close to the grass there because I can kick it right back fair. If they're not rushing in at it.
Yeah.
You'd hate to lose that one.
Well, Kirby keeps the lines pretty clean, though. I don't think
yes, he does.
There's strike three on the outside. Nice pitch by Torgerson.
Now up to bat number five, Drew Johnson.
So that brings up the top of the order for the Wolves, Drew Johnson. Johnson scored the Wolves' first run in the first. We reached on a walk, grounded out in the second, reached on a hit in the fourth, and grounded out in the sixth. First pitch is high for a ball. That almost hit him.
It was a good move to get away from it.
Yeah, his teammates are telling him to wear it.
Yeah, that ball stings a little in the cold, you know. That hurts a little bit more.
Well, I think he was trying to wear it, but he just somehow acrobatically missed it by like half an inch.
So we got 3-0 here, the count.
Let's see if Johnson's taking on this. He is all the way, and he'll take his four-pitch walk. So one out, runner on first now for the Wolves. That's going to bring up Cade Chittum, who's now pitching for the Wolves. Chittum at the plate, flew out in the first, reached on a hit in the second, grounded out in the fourth, and grounded out in the sixth.
There we go.
First pitch strike from Torgerson. That one's just a little low. Curveball doesn't quite come down. So 2-1 the count now. Wolves have basically bunted in this position with everyone except Chittum, I think.
He's probably got a good swing.
That one's low.
3-1.
Yeah. Plus when the previous batter drew a four-pitch walk, maybe you want to be a little patient and see how it plays out with the next few pitches. And there's a second walk. So Torgerson, second walk in the inning. Runners on first and second now.
Number 13, Drew Marolt.
That's going to bring up Drew Marolt.
Started out with a good strike out there to get us started here with one out. But we've now walked two on. So runners on first and second.
Marolt's had a good day at the plate. He's 2-for-3 with a run score. Well, wait, he one hit, one walk, and scored a run back in the first. There's a nice pitch on the outside edge for strike one.
Vierling trying to hold the runner at second.
Pitch is high. So 1-1. Plenty of speed on the base for the Wolves.
Be great to get another strike out here.
There's a swing and a miss. Torgerson pulled the string on him. Marolt was way out in front.
Yeah, one ball, two strikes here.
Does
there
it again.
We go.
Just what you ordered up, Dan, the strikeout. So two out now for the Wolves.
I'd be in a lot better position if I could call lottery tickets. You know that, Brent?
Well, we have to use your special powers for good. That's going to bring up sophomore Hunter Hallbachen batting for the first time in the game.
That's ball one. We got two outs here, runner on first and second. 1-0 the count.
There's a shot to short. Stieber grabs it, flips to second for the out. Nice play by the Knights. The Wolves threaten, get two runners on with walks, but Knights are able to shut it down after seven and a half. We're still tied at four. Knights with their chance to win the game coming up after this.
Oh, beautiful, far spacious skies, far amber waves of grain, far purple mountain majesties.
I'm Robin Brimehurst, and you're watching the Knights Activity Network. Let's go!
Welcome back. Bottom of the eighth. Mason Torgerson up for the Knights.
There we go.
Drives one to third. Third baseman's on it. He's got an arm too. Able to throw him out. Good play. Nice play by Owen Marolt at third. So that's going to bring up Tanner Dean. Tanner's had, he reached on an error, or he reached on a single in the sixth and stole a base. He's one for three on the day.
There
he drives one. Drifts it over.
Oh,
great catch by the left fielder.
Nice diving catch.
Ran in, dove at the last minute. That's left fielder Sam Leeson with a great play. So the Knights.
I thought that was going to drive for sure. He came a long way in.
I mean, our bats are heating up. We had two hard hit balls in contact. Just
two pitches.
Two good plays by the Wolves defense here. That's going to bring up Reed Summer. Summers scored a run.
Reed had a sacrifice fly, which I believe scored. Must have been Butch. Yep. In the seventh. That's what got us our tying run.
Yep. So Summer, one run scored and one RBI on the day. It's not a bad day when you got four runs total. He almost pulled the trigger. He should have. It was right on the outside edge. So 2-1 the count.
Sorry, that was wrong. Van Epp scored in the seventh.
Ball way outside. So 3-1 now to Summer. Two out. Be good to get him on first. So my guess is he'd be on second pretty quick. Shows bunt, pulls it away, and it's strike on the outside edge. So now the count's full. Summer's going to have to earn it. Pitch is low. So Reed will be on first.
Yeah, you won't be going to second on this one.
You don't think so?
No. Everybody clap
your hands. Steberg's up.
Well, I meant on that overthrow, though.
Oh, on the overthrow.
On the block. On the block, yeah. He was thinking about it.
I was going to say, I'm pretty sure he's going to be, I would think, with his speed, Kirby's going to be looking to send him and get somebody in scoring position with two
out. This catcher's got a good arm, though.
There he goes. Strike. Catcher.
Ooh, he's in there.
Didn't quite get it. Two hopped at the second. Summers able to beat out the throw. So now you got a runner in scoring position for the Knights. Two out.
Need a hit here.
Steberg at the plate, 0-1 count. Steberg's reached on an error or reached on a walk.
Reed's got a good lead at second. No one's holding him.
That one's just a bit outside. That was close, especially those pitches. They've got a lot of break at the last minute. That one's inside. Ooh. I thought that was a strike, but he's called a ball.
That one
gets by. I'm here. Summer got a lot late start. Here it comes. He's down there and wins the game for the Knights. Great play by Summer. Stealing third. Throw gets by the third baseman. Summer took a bit to realize it was by him. By the time he got up, it made it really close at home, but he was able to make it as the throw was just a little off base.
Great win by the Knights. Good base running by Reed Summers. Good calls by Kirby to get him where he was at.
Great.
Don't forget to join us here tomorrow. We'll be playing at 1-3 Cherry and International Falls. Be a fun day at the ballpark if you can come down for a cup of hot chocolate and a hot dog. Thanks, everybody. Have a good night.
Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow.